What's up, guys? It's Friday. You know what that means? I don't know what that means. Every day is work day for me. So, guys, yesterday was a crazy day. Actually, it's typically that's how it goes. I usually get a whole bunch of jobs lined up, and I touched about 6 cars yesterday, guys, and worked on about 4 of them. And every single car that I worked on got fixed. I did 2 diagnostics, and I don't know if I captured everything on film, but I mean, I had to review, you know, 1.5 hours worth of footage, and I trimmed it down to about 30 minutes. So hopefully today we get some good, you know, good footage of some work. Yesterday, this vehicle, it's a Mitsubishi Mirage, got dropped off for a starter issue. So when they dropped it off, I wasn't here. I got back home after a long day. I took the kids out to martial arts class. And when I was in bed, it must have been midnight while I was editing, I said, man, I never grabbed those keys from that customer. I wonder if they're in my mailbox. Well, I couldn't sleep, so I came out and it was unlocked. And because I was in a rush, there was a car coming up the street and I was in my underwear. I ended up just locking it. And this morning I found out the keys are stuck in it. So I've already opened it real quick. This is what I used to open it, guys. I bought this, it's about a 6-foot rod. I bought it from Home Depot in an emergency once while I was working. Didn't have anything that was long enough to open up this pickup. The only one that I had was this pink unlocking tool, right? Vehicle unlocking tool. And it's only about, I'd say probably 2.5 feet. I bought it from O'Reilly's, it was on sale. And now I understand why it was on sale, because there's not many vehicles that can open. But I still use the hell out of it. But aside from that, I have this from Home Depot. I bought this tool. It's to level doors when they're installing them. I like this one because it's heavy duty. And the only thing is, over time, obviously rubber will start decaying or tearing or stretching. So I had to put some electrical tape on the edges. I'm sure some glue would have helped out better, but it still works like a champ. So far I got that car opened up. We'll be doing the starter on that, and then we'll also be doing some brakes on the Toyota Camry that I looked at yesterday, and a brake caliper on it as well. I got my rim nice and dry. It's been about 2 to 3 days. As you can see, it's evenly painted. There's no, I think they call it like tiger spots or something like that. I can't remember what they call it, but it looks amazing. I still got to do those 3, so I'll keep you guys posted on those. Wait, guys, check this out. So I came to the parts store. I was grabbing some parts, washing my hands, and look what I found. What the hell? That's a radiator hose, guys, next to some lotion. What kind of tragedies are going on here? By the time I got outside, I seen this on the ground, and I wasn't surprised. I'm back. So, unfortunately, I don't really have a lot of battery left to spare on this job. I've already got it taken apart, guys. I took off the brakes and rotors on this side. And you guys know the drill. I'm gonna clean and lube the caliper pins. This side actually had a bad, you guys can see it right there, had a bad control arm, not a control arm, I'm sorry, a inner tie rod end. So I was able to pick that up at the parts store. And the brake caliper had gotten stuck, it was sticking on this side. So I'm replacing that also. It's 2 17 millimeter bolts that hold on the caliper, and the actual caliper bracket is 2 17 millimeter bolts, and the caliper is 14 millimeter bolts, okay? So you guys know the drill. It's pretty much straight and forward. Let me show you guys. I upgraded his brake pads to the import directs, which he's gonna appreciate because the last ones didn't last more than a year. Not to mention the caliper was sticking, but here's a new rotors pads under warranty. And then obviously the inner tie rod end. This is the new one, comes with new hardware. This is the old one, guys, check this out. It literally, it's hard to do it with one hand, but look at all that play. I told them that we can do the driver's side also, but it doesn't have as much play as the passenger side, but he wants to wait on that. But guys, if you know anybody having issues like this, this is so crucial to being safe on the road. Make sure that they don't take no for an answer when it's that bad. This one, we can deal with that maybe in a couple months, but never put somebody at risk. All right, guys, so I'm gonna get back on this and get back to you guys after. Really quickly, I wanna give some advice. When you guys are changing out the inner tie rod ends or the outer tie rod ends, what you can do, there's different methods, people, I'm sure, online that can show you how to do it so you can get the right length of it. What I do is I just line up the back side of it and I mark the front of the tie rod end, right? So once you're there, you're able to obviously measure, right? So this one, I think it's 16. I get it from the mark that I have it of the tie rod end, and then I got about 16 3/8. So I'll use this standard measuring tape, so that way it shows me all the small decimals. So 16 3/8, and that'll be a lot easier installing it on that one. And then you could just go back and measure it from this line to the end, make sure it's the same length. Okay, guys, just a pointer. Hey guys, another thing I wanted to give advice on, this customer, his rack and pinion boot is torn, and he didn't want to spend any more money on ordering the part and having it come in and having me come out and replacing it. So what I did is I had this rubber glove, I tore a finger off, and I just slid it right on there, and you could hardly see it, but the actual glove comes up to here, and I cut the tip off so I can just, you know, slide it on like a rubber. And there you go, guys, nice little boot. It's obviously not the best thing in the world, but it'll hold. When you guys are installing these inner tie rod ends, there's these two notches that you'll see at the end of the rack and pinion. Well, those notches belong on this washer, you know, tabs that are sticking out. So make sure you guys line that up. And once you guys get done torquing that down, what I do is I use a pipe wrench, and that helps get a lot of leverage on it. Once you guys do that and you guys got it on there tight, you're gonna wanna bend the washers down where these flat spots are. Okay, so it doesn't back out. All right, guys.
What's up, guys? Oh my gosh. I felt like I was there all damn day, and I was only there for 3 hours. From the moment I left the house, it'd been 3 hours since I got back home. So I definitely charged exactly what was necessary for that job. Luckily for them, they were able to save a lot of money with the warranty of the brake pads and rotors. Everything checked out excellent, didn't have any issues. When you guys are installing the inner tie rod end, make sure you guys put a just a tad bit of the Loctite. The Loctite is gonna help give it that extra secure mint that it needs to be safe for your customer or for yourself. But please, guys, if you guys have any questions about any of the work that I'm doing, just ask. I'll be more than happy to comment, maybe even exchange some information. I can send you some information. I do brakes every week, so I can point something out that I might have missed. But yeah, anyhow, all right, on to the next one, guys. Not sure what I'm gonna be doing today. It's about 2 p.m. and I'm thinking about just sanding the hell out of those rims. I gotta get them ready for Monday. So those tires are coming in Monday. It's gonna be I'm excited for it. It's gonna be an awesome thing for my truck. It's gonna give it that look that I've been wanting, the beefy look on the tires. My tires are all different right now, and that's how that got the truck when I first, you know, purchased it a year ago. So, you know, tires, wheels, and then hopefully I can do some paint sometime by the, you know, early next month. So I'll keep you guys posted on that. All right, guys, I'll get back to you. I'm here back with the rims. We're gonna be, I've already hit it with the 100 grit. I gotta do it with the 220 and the 320 and get it nice and ready for possibly primer tonight or tomorrow morning. These suckers got to be ready for Monday. Guys, it's nearly 1 a.m. I got about 20 more minutes till 1. This is the second rim. No, actually, that's the third one. I already got the second one done. This is the last one. Everything's checking out good. So I switched it up a little bit. I brought up the AC because it was about 90 degrees in here, it seemed like. I picked up some P80 to give it the first sand, and it took, I mean, it was aggressive, right? After that, I went over it with the 120, 220, and the 320. And after that, it, you know, it left a really smooth finish for the primer. So this is primered. See how nice and smooth that looks. I ended up buying 2 more cans of primer black and 2 more cans of the black Saturn color for the wheel. Come Monday, we'll stop by my brother's shop and slap those nice 10-ply tires. I ended up going with the 245 75 16s. I was gonna go with the 265 75 16s, but we've seen some pictures online, and most of the vans that had it, they had to get a lift. So obviously we're not doing that on my work truck. But the 245 is what it calls for. We're going all terrains. I think they're the Cooper Discovery, AT3s, 10-ply. So they're really good wheels, tires. So I'm excited for that, but it has to be done. I got 50 Cent. I have a bunch of hip hop, rap. I mean, I'm all over country. I got some opera in there, some Mozart. Dude, I'm hitting every damn avenue in these headphones to stay awake. So it is what it is, guys. I want to do this for me, and I also want to show you guys that whatever you got to get done, this is grown man business. So I got some Coors Lights keeping me up. So it's my second, maybe my third one. I don't get buzzed now, you know, at this age. I, you know, with Coors Lights as it is, but yeah, guys, just bear with me. Tomorrow I don't have a schedule lined up, but I have a ton of work to do. I got 2 new jobs that came by tonight, so tomorrow's gonna be one of those good days. A lot of footage to go over at the end of the night. All right, guys, this is the last one for the night. It's actually the fourth one, so I'm gonna hit it with the gray primer. I might as well show you guys this last one. And what I was saying earlier is I go really heavy on the edges. So
this one sitting here, sitting on three bolts, so that way it can get as much as drying time as possible on every surface. It's looking good, guys. I know I said I was gone, guys, for the day, but guess what? It's Saturday. It's 3 a.m. now. I never gave up. I came with you guys with raw footage. I got done sanding and priming all the rest of the wheels. Can't even talk right. I'm so high up in this garage. So much damp overspray. I was entertained by editing some of the last footage, so guys, I didn't want to go without showing you guys it got done. Okay, guys, so you guys know the finishing product for the primer. This is it. So we'll let that sit overnight. We'll sand it with some 800 grit, and then paint them. Yeah, thanks, guys, for sure. Now, taking a shower, going to bed. Thanks, guys. See you on the next one.